Hi everyone, welcome to the SOPIA tutorial language session 7. So in this tutorial we'll be looking into the property transfer in SOPIA. So how we can transfer one SOP request response property to another SOP request. Okay, so it may happen that your two SOP requests contain in different level, like in different test case or maybe in different test suite or in different project. So we'll be seeing that how we can transfer one SOP request property to another. Okay, so let's get started. We'll have a look into it. My SOPIA version 5.2.1 that I'm currently using. This is a free version, so let me show you how you can use the property transfer. Okay, so I'm using this project, like Medicare Supplier. This is the project you will get. The WHL file is available in the over the internet. Okay, so this is the file path that I've incorporated. This is the WHL file. Okay, and test suite and those things is I will give them. Okay. And if you click on that, we'll get the overview, that namespace, binding, all these things, and service endpoint we are also able to see. Okay, so next big thing is that we are having different options, like get supplier by city, get supplier by supply type, get supplier by zip code. We can see in the request one, if we search like a city like Seattle, and we get let me see the whatever we'll get the supplier list, all the supplier list for this city Seattle. Okay, along with the supplier number, company name, address number, zip code, G++, telephone, description, everything I'm getting. Okay, after posting the SOP request. Okay, if we change the same, I mean change it to like California. So accordingly we will get all those things. Okay, the next biggest thing that I have taken those requests inside my test suite, that is my test suite created, get supply by city chip, and inside the test suite I have four different test cases. So let me take you to my first test cases. Okay, first is second test case. Yeah, second test cases. So see, I mean inside the test case, customer settle, I mean this is the test case, I mean don't go with the name, I mean inside the test case I have total four step. Okay, the total four step has been given. Just hold on. Yeah, total four step has been given. The first step is country name, that is blank. Just a minute. It will display the property. Okay. So this, inside this total four test step. This is the test step. Country name taken or parameter. The country Seattle that I'm actually passing. Okay. You can also use the, if you're using the, I mean, Ready API or the SOPI Pro version, then you can use the data source to get the country name from the data source, to paste the country name from the data source. Okay, so this is the request. So this request, if you see, it's fetching the data, fetching the, I mean, the city I'm passing, passing it from the country name. Just click on it, get data from test suite level, get data from country name, step one country name, the country I'm giving. So country name, this is the properties, and inside the properties I've given country as value as Seattle. So it will search for Seattle. So for Seattle it will search and it will fetch all the list for the Seattle. Now I suppose I want to use that zip code. Okay, so particular zip code 98146 and I want to use the zip code 98125. Yes, some particular whatever the zip code you want, zip code 98106, and I want to pass the zip code to my next request. So in, after the second request, it's showing the get supplier by zip code. So first, I'm gonna searching. I want to I'm getting all the supplier list by city. Then I'm passing the zip code to get all the supplier list by zip code. Okay. So whatever the response I will get inside through the city. And I need to provide the zip code to the to this SOP request. Okay, so how we can do that? For that we need to have someone need to add one test step, that is the property transfer test step. So just click on that add step and the property transfer. Okay, so I've already added this property, I mean test. Let me open it. So this is my property transfer test step. So we can see so this is my Seattle, this is the response I have got. Open my response. Let me open my property transfer. Okay, so first you have to check click on the portions namespace, so that the namespace have been given. You should declare your namespace. Currently my namespace NS1 HTTP web service .net that I'm using, and the show versions namespace you also have to provide. Now next thing is that I'm using the XPath, so NS1 subnet 2 and NS1 G+4 a text I'm fetching. Okay, the text I'm fetching. So subnet 2 supply data, this is supply first supply data, the second supply data is supply data. Okay, so this is, it will go to the second supply data, and then NS1 G+4, and inside that NS1 you have to mention this is the names for default, and inside the second supply data you have to go to the G+4. So I'm navigating the G+4, I'm getting the text 98146, I'm getting the text 98146. Okay, so you can see, just you have to, I mean, whatever you are doing, suppose you want to face the particular city name, a zip code name, just you have to make sure you have to face the XPath, and you have to provide the XPath in the property transfer. Okay, so in the source, I mean from the response obviously you have to choose the get supplier by city, this is the request, and from this request response I want to get. So the get supplier by city request response, so the response I've got, this is the response. This is the response I have got. From this response, I want to fetch the zip code. So I'm fetching the from the properties the response, and path language you can choose XPath, XQuery, JSON path, but for SOAP XPath will be used. So choosing XPath, and the namespace I have provided. And one more thing, guys, you have to make sure first, if you create, you will get a blank. All those things you need to create one property. Just click on the add a property transfer, so you have to create some property value. Okay, I mean just property name you have to create. Okay, so I've created one property name already, transfer zip code response request. Okay, so it's fetching the XPath value from that response. Let me check it is working or not. Okay, so we can see, I mean the transfer name is whatever the property name I'm added, and the transfer value is 98146. It's fetching successfully. Now I have successfully fetched the property text from the response. Now I want to pass it to my next request. So target request may be your different test case, a different suite, or you can say add it to some test case or test suite, project level properties or global properties. For my case, I'm saving it to the test get supplied by city zip code. I want to pass it to the second test set. Okay, I'm passing it to here, get supplied by zip code. So where I'm passing, at the request point. Okay, so property request, and I have to provide the XPath. So first, just like before, we have to declare the namespace for this also. And if we navigate to it, we can see this is the zip path, so ns1:zip. This is the XPath locations. There, here I have to provide the property. Okay. Okay, so ns1.zip, so I'm providing. So what it is basically do, it will fetch the zip code from my first response, and it will provide the zip code to my second step request. Okay, now suppose this is the first supply data, this is the second supply data, this is the third supply data. Suppose I want to have want to pass first supply zip code. First supply zip code is 98146. So 98146, I need to mention the property. This is the first supply zip code. So here I have to mention as 1. Okay. G+4 will be same. Let me just quick run it and we'll see the result. So it's fetching the country from the country name properties and transfer the properties. So let me just call it. Okay. So first it fetches the country name, then it's fetching the supplier name by city. City is passing from this country name properties. Then it's doing the property transfer. Okay, property transfer. It fetches the zip code from the response and it's passing to the next request, next SOAP request, and then get supplied by city zip code. It's sending the request with the zip code. If we navigate to that, we can see it's successfully passed. And if I see the property transfer 98125, this is the property that has been transferred successfully. Okay, 98125, this is my first zip code, first supplier zip code. So 98125 passing. If I provide the second supply zip code, if I want to pass, let me just put this here and let me run it again. Close it. Close this one. Okay, let me run it again. I am passing the second supplier zip code. So it's passed successfully. If we navigate to that, it should pass 98146. This is the message response that I've got. This is a request and this is the response I've got for this. Okay. And properties is the default property that we've given. So we can see this way, like we can add the property transfer to supply our property value from one request to another request. It may be located in separate test case, test suite, or some different in different level, a test case, a project level also you can set. Okay, and the important thing is that I would like to show that let me show you one example for the sample project. Okay, let me give you an example for this simple project login test case that we have options. Not login. Not before. Login logout test suite. Login test case. Okay. So let me take one example. This is the login logout test suite that is for a simple this URL WSDL and the service endpoint I'm currently using. And suppose you have logged into some provide direct credential, even logged into some particular website, and then successfully some session ID will be created, right? So now I want to log out, so I have to put the session ID. If the session is invalid, I won't be logging out successfully. Okay, so here we can see we are using the four SOAP requests that are login, logout, search, buy. I created one mock response over here. Let me show you for this. Buy and search I don't need as of now. Just remove this. So in the login, this first I'm going to let me start the mock service. This is showing. I'm showing you for mock service. Okay, how we can do it. And okay, so suppose this is my SOAP request. I'm providing the username login and login 123. Okay, clicking on that, after successfully login, the session ID has been created 697433. This is my session ID has been created. I want to, and if I navigate to the logout, escape, logout. Yeah, if I want to logged out from the website, I need to put the session ID. If I don't know the session ID, it won't be logged out. Just put some random session ID, click on next, we'll get some error. Okay, that's the error we'll get. So I need to provide the exact session ID. So how can I provide? So this is my first test case and this is my second test case. So I need to transfer the session ID from the first test case to the second test case. For this, I will be using property transfer. So let's see for the login. This is a property has been created. I want to transfer this property. So I've taken one step, property transfer. this is the step. And see, this is the expert object, so will be session login response, then colon session ID. Okay, first you need to add one property as per, then one added one property session ID, then the source is the login. This is the login step, and I want to fetch the session ID from the response expert have given as a NS1 login response session ID. Okay, and the target is the test suite login logout test suite. I'm moving the whatever the we are getting that session ID, I'm passing the login logout test suite session ID. So if you see in the custom properties, I've created one property session ID. Here we are passing this one, just run it. Session ID is 6943. This is, I am passing this to the suite level property value. Okay, so whatever response I'm getting, I'm passing it to the test suite custom properties. And from the custom properties, if you navigate the logout, if you give it like get data from test suite and from property session ID, so it's fetching the ID from the test suite session ID. Okay, if I just click on, just hold on, it's running on box. If I click on the logout, logout response is coming as okay. If I again click on, it's showing as invalid session ID. Why? Because it doesn't successfully logged out. Okay, similarly, if I want to log in again, click on login, the new session ID will generate. If I click on logout, I need to in process these steps also. Run selected property transfers. Property transfer will successfully transfer this value, and then I need to click on logout. It's coming as okay. So this is my sample test suite. Okay, let me run this test suite. Okay. So this is test suite login and logout has successfully passed, and we can see the response. This time session ID 51. This is new session ID got generated. And if I want to, if I already have session ID and user is already logged in, suppose I logged in and I'm getting a new session ID. If I just click on again, so I should get a message like it's already logged in. Okay, so it's won't allow me to log in again because you have already logged in with this account. Okay. Okay, I mean, so guys, we have seen that utilizing the test property transfer, we can also utilize it for mock service and for real service also, and we can use it inside our test case, test step level, and so that we can transfer property from the response to the another test script or on another test case request, or we can also directly use it as a property to as a test suite property or test case, or we can also include at a global level property. We already have that options. Okay, so also we